Why should we touch the feet of elders? Have you ever thought of it? हमें बड़ों के पांव क्यों छूने चाहिए? To give respect to elders. Okay, right? We touch the feet of our relatives, parents, grandparents, other relatives who are elder than us. Some of the children touch the feet of even their brothers and sisters who are elder than them, maybe 1 year or so. It depends upon the upbringing of a child. There are scientific reasons also behind touching the feet. Mythologically, if we see, at the time of Mahabharata, Yudhishthir had stated once that touching the feet of my elders gave me strength, power, courage, and energy with which I can rule my kingdom better. And all the Rishi Munis, sages, saints, they had also advocated about touching the feet because they felt that by touching the feet of elders, we get the knowledge, wisdom, intellect, blessings on top of all from those elders. Do you agree that your elders came to this world before you? So when we touch the feet of our elders, whatever experience, knowledge, wisdom they have acquired throughout their life, that knowledge, wisdom, intellect, some part of that gets transferred to our body as well in the form of energy. The whole universe is dependent upon energy. And when you study science, it is clearly mentioned there that energy can neither be created nor destroyed. It can only change from one form of energy to another form of energy. Right? So, this energy keeps flowing throughout the universe, from one body to another body, from one form to another form. And that energy, which is supposed to be more in the people who have spent more time in this world, gained more energy from the various forms and bodies of this world, so they have become the storehouse of energy, your elders. Okay? And when you touch their feet, through this touch, there is a connection which is built. And that energy gets transferred to your body as well. So, suppose a person is standing next to you, and when you touch the feet of that person, you touch the body of that person. And the energy flows through his body to your body and again back. So it completes that circuit of energy, and it is supposed that the left side of human body contains negative energy and right side of human body contains positive energy. Electric circuit mein bhi aise hi hota na, negative and positive. So this is very much scientific reason behind touching the feet of elders. Why should we touch? Because the energy, the knowledge, the wisdom, the courage, the strength which they have acquired, some part of it gets transferred to us as well. We become better than we were before touching their feet. Another reason is from the point of view of health. Okay, in yoga there is an asana which is called Padhastasana. Pad we call feet, hast we call hand, and when we touch either our feet or somebody's feet like this, there are many benefits of this asana. The blood circulation becomes better, your nerves become more active, your spine becomes healthier, body, mind, and soul, all three get benefited by touching the feet of elders, because whenever you will touch the feet of elders, you are doing it out of gratitude, and they will feel happy They will have more compassion on you, more love on you, and they will give you blessings. And it is said in Hindu mythology that once in a day, Goddess Saraswati resides on the tongue of people. And you never know if you are touching the feet of your elders and when they are giving you blessings, maybe sometime on any elder's tongue, the Goddess Saraswati is residing at that time. And if they give you that blessings, may you live long, may you become very rich, may you become very famous, may you score very good marks in exams, may be that will become truth. So many benefits of touching the feet of elders, but I feel very bad when I see what is happening these days. When the kids are small, younger in age, nursery, LKG, UKG, first and second, and when they touch the feet of elders, they are very pure, very pious, blank slates, no ego. They go all the way down to the feet. But as you keep growing, you go into second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth class, the extent of your bending down decreases. You will reach till here, slowly till here, slowly till here, and slowly till here. And without bending, you'll do this. Ask yourself, the elders, the grown-ups. We say, Papa ji pairi pehna, Mummy ji pairi pehna, Dada ji pairi pehna. And what should I say to this, what you people do? Sir, pinni pehna. Sir, gode pehna. Sir, pat pehna. Right? Isko pairi pehna to nahi bol sakte na, beta? What benefits you are going to draw out of that? I'm not saying that you should touch the feet of everyone. I'm just saying when you touch the feet, it should be out of respect for the person whose feet you're touching. It is not that because the other person has touched the feet, you also have to touch the feet. It is not mandatory. It's not a must for you. You can simply wish good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever you want to. Or you can simply say Namaste, Sat Sri Akal. Don't do it for the sake of showing it. Because the others are doing it, so I also have to do it. Otherwise, pata nahi, sir, ma'am, kya bolenge. First of all, make your mind clear. Whether you want to touch the feet of A person or B person or C person or not. For what reason do you want to touch the feet of that person? Do you feel that person is elder than you? Do you feel that person has acquired more knowledge than you? Do you feel that person has something in terms of blessings to give to you or not? If you feel that you are going to gain something out of that person, definitely touch the feet of that person. But mind it, I am talking about touching the feet. Not the shin bone, not the knees, not the thigh. This is not the way. This is not our culture. So next time I expect you people will understand what I mean to tell you and you will not do the formalities. If you will touch somebody's feet, you will touch with respect. There is one more thing which if I will not clarify, the talk will be incomplete, and that is about the girls. Why do girls not touch the feet of the parents or the grandparents or the family members? Right? क्यों नहीं करती हैं? Girls क्यों नहीं touch करती हैं? Girls को क्यों बोला जाता है कि आप feet touch नहीं करोगे? Come on. The girl is supposed to be an incarnation of goddess. Somebody says goddess Lakshmi, somebody says goddess Durga, somebody says goddess Saraswati, but we treat girls as goddess in our family, Devi. Okay, that's why we do Kanya Pujan. Kanjken dete hai na? Navratro mein, we do Kanya Pujan. Reason behind that is this only, that we treat our daughters or our sisters as goddesses. Hum unke paon chhute hain, unse paon nahi chhuate. It is said in Hindu mythology, ki ek father ke liye, sabse bada daan koi agar wo life mein kar sakta hai, wo kanya ka daan hai. We believe ki if the girls will touch our feet, they will become inferior to us. And the thing which is to be given as a daan has to be superior one. So our daughters, our sisters, our girls have to be superior than us. Humse bhi badi cheez ka daan hum dete hain. That's why we don't allow the girls to touch our feet. But when they get married, they become the family member of that another family. And as a member, they have to pay the respect and regard to the elders over there. Then they start touching the feet of that family. Right? So I hope this thing is also clear to you people. And what message I want you to give is clear to all. And everybody will understand the real reasons behind touching the feet and will not show off in front of anybody. So make your mind clear. If you want to touch anybody's feet, touch it with full respect and please touch the feet, not the knees and thighs. Thank you.